Boys, I'm here with my bros.
I'm Dante.
I'm Ryan.
Kenneth. Hey.
And I'm Will Sijenko, and together we're R2D2.
Yeah! Yeah, the boys. Bounce.
On January 10th, 2017, a car ran through the Bourke Street Mall, killing 6 people. This is a tragic event, and Melbourne had to do something about it. What did they do? They put bollards all around the city, causing controversy and a lot of praise for the city. Now today, we're going to be looking at everything about bollards. We have had bollards for ages. The ones that were put in after the Bourke Street attacks are made out of concrete, and they've only been around for a short amount of time. But the ones that we have that have been around for ages are metal. They've always been to stop our cars from entering pedestrian areas.
Oh, let's get right into the bollards!
Have you heard of the bollards around Melbourne?
I have heard of the bollards. I've sighted them at Spencer Street Station. And I'm well aware of the need for them to be put in after that Bourke Street.
So have you heard of the bollards around Melbourne? Yeah.
Yep.
Do you know their purpose?
Yep.
Cool.
I heard about them. I've seen things in the media about them, and I've seen them like on the bridge up there and around the train stations. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. These are the concrete blocks you've got back here.
Pardon? Yep.
These are the concrete blocks.
Yeah. Yeah.
So have you heard of the bollards?
Yes, I have.
Do you know what the purpose of them is?
Yes.
That makes it so much easier.
Crime prevention?
Well, I guess you're talking about vehicle security, so stopping vehicle access.
To prevent another terrorist attack after the Bourke Street Mall incident, yeah.
At the moment, I think they are going to improve them, I understand that, but I do think they're a bit of an eyesore at the moment. I don't think they're attractive to the city, but I can see that there's certainly something that we deem necessary at this point in time.
I actually hate them. Like, I'm an architect for a living, so I do design for my job every day, and I think they're pretty awful. Like, I've seen the new ones that they've just put into Bourke Street Mall with the planters in them. They're a lot better. This one, the hamburger down there, is pretty funny, but they're just like, being such big concrete blocks, they're kind of just like a reminder of something bad that happened.
I don't mind people doing it. It's, you know, it's all right, but it'd be nice if there was some sort of unity to it at a moment, like they gave these bollards to this group of artists or something, so it just doesn't look so messy.
Yeah, I think it's a great idea. Art enriches life, so you've got something there. So they're there for a quite sad reason, but to take that and turn it into a thing of beauty or art is a positive thing.
Yeah, I think it's fine. Yeah. I mean, I think it's fine. I don't know if it's called like graffiti or whatever, but
they do stick out. So they are an opportunity for someone to have a voice where they may not have that voice normally.
When something obtrusive like this comes into our lives, we really have to think about what's the right balance between safety and being restricted. We already have so many safety things put in place. We need to think about if this is really right.
There's some real questions here. Are we really free? What is our freedom? What does it mean? Are we free to do whatever we want? Or are we restricted by simple rules that serve no purpose at all, apart from to restrict us? We're not allowed to do what we want to do, but more in the interest of everyone else in our society. Maybe that's a good thing, maybe that's a bad thing. I don't know.